everyone. Now, in this video, I am going to vlog my midterm reflections in this subject, History 11, where my first topic is all about Act of Declaration of Philippine Independence. This topic was the time that President Emilio Aguinaldo proclaimed the independence of the Philippines from the Spanish colonial rule in the Cavite, El Viejo Cavite. Also, this declaration proclaiming the sovereignty and independence of the Philippine Islands from the colonial rule of Spain, where this declaration of Philippine independence declared because it is purposely to rally the troops, win foreign allies, and to announce the creation of a new country to be an independence. That this act of declaration was the most important part of the history, and it gives evidence indicating the proclamation of the freedom and sovereignty of our homeland Philippines from the colonialist and imperialist of Spain. That in the time we can back our rights, we can have our freedom, that we are significantly belong to us as a person in this world from birth until we dead, and freedom to do all we wanted to do in this world, freedom to choose to act and to talk freely as we want. That this topic is really significant on us individuals living in this world, that to be an independent person, to do and to act all we want on ourselves. And next, my second reflection topic on midterm is entitled 1899 Constitution of the Republic of the Philippines, Malolos Convention. This topic is the beginning of our country as a democratic republication government country, with the help of three branches, the executive, legislative, and the judicial branches. This is importantly called for the separation of church and the state, and it created a Filipino state whose government was popular, representative, responsible, or trustable. In this category topic, I can feel excitement and happiness by the constitution that were usually made or do to help the country revolution and development, because also of the beginning of our democratic country. Also, this topic has been started because to provide the safeguards against abuses and enumerated the national individual rights, not only on Filipinos and for the aliens. Also, to have the first important Filipino document ever produced by the people's representative, it signifies the democratic tradition that ultimately had the roots in American soil. In our country here, with this democratic country, we can have our freedom in the way we can express our feelings around the world. We can freely act, speak, and think without the hindrance of restraint of other people, usually making us people all independently on every situation. And we can all live independently, individually, in this country. And next, my third midterm reflection is entitled about Treaty of Peace between the United States of America and the Kingdom of Spain, Treaty of Paris. This topic is really discusses about the peace agreement or the peace negotiation about United States of America and the United Kingdom that it is signed on the Paris on the 10th day of December 1898 by Spain and United States that ended the Spanish-American War. This agreement also, or term, also ended the age of Spanish imperialism and established the United States as a world power. That with this agreement, the two countries have been made articles for making their peace agreement done or started. That these few these articles which they negotiated can make them have a better understanding and good connection about their thoughts and ideas about each other, making good negotiation and understanding in a truth that it will result to better effects on each countries they hold or they lead. Significantly, when both parties understand each other, also they lead can be affected as they will also affect their thoughts and understanding about what they do. And also, what has been they declared, it can also be affected the people that they have been leaded. That, as a matter of fact, I feel about it is happiness and importance, because as we all know, peace is an good way about preventing conflict about each other to make a wonderful communication and negotiation on each other. And next, for my fourth midterm reflection in History 11 is entitled about Jose Rizal's Retraction Controversy. As I understand this topic, this is all about Jose Rizal wanted to be a true Catholic person, for him to act the actions of Catholic individual, and on that religion he wanted to say that on what his decision he wishes to dedicate his life on the time he live and die. That for me, it is really an loyal sayings as a person that he wanted to be a Catholic person and to dedicate his life as a being Catholic if even he is still alive and he is dead. And having knowing this retraction controversy of Jose Rizal give me an understanding that things at taking back what you were said or what you were stating will make your situation confused. For as a matter of fact, that knowing that is this retraction letter of Dr. Jose Rizal really makes him loyal and religious person, that he really wanted to dedicate his life on the Catholic Church, even his spontaneous sins, and he do cause and he wishes to God and people will pardon him. That actually, I feel about this topic is heart-tearing, because Jose Rizal tell here that he really wanted to be a Catholic person, that even though in a truth he have so many sins in his life, he is not a perfect person and he is a rational thinker. That he said that even though what happens, he really wanted to be a Catholic person or a religion to do all the actions and scenarios of of being a Catholic person in his life. And next, for my fifth reflection topic here in the midterm is entitled about convention between the United States of America and Great Britain. This topic is usually all about the agreement between the governments of United States and the United Kingdom to significantly determine the boundary, their boundary between the North Borneo and the Philippine Archipelago. That here, they conducted five articles that containing their agreement to be started and have been declared. That for me, knowing these articles is very important to me as a student in a reason is can included to my new more knowledge about the past history of the Philippines to make me not an ignorant person to know all the scenarios and happenings here in our country, that especially the happenings about the Philippine islands in the archipelago that were claimed the north and east is belong to our country, that also for us individuals to relive as they are governed and claimed by the country of the Philippines. And next, for my sixth reflection topic on the midterm is entitled about Philippine-American War. This is about the war between the United States and the Filipino Revolutionary from 1899 to 1902, an organized and usually violent war act of revolt that may be seen as a continuation of Philippine revolutionaries against Spanish rule. Also, in this war, this is resulted over 4,200 American and over 20,000 Filipino combatants, Filipino soldiers were died on the bloody war. As many 200,000 Filipino civilians died from violence, famine, and disease. That, as a matter of fact, even though this war is ended and done, we might not forget the sacrifices of our fellow Filipino soldiers who fight for our countries to be protected and defended. And the time the war was temporarily gave United States colonial control of the Philippines. That for me, having this knowledge is very important, that the sacrifices of our fellow Filipino, that they sacrificed their own self for our country's freedom and life. And next, for my seventh reflection topic on midterm is entitled about American period. The American period is really about the situation and scenarios on how the peace agreement allowed the United States of America gain possession of the Philippine Islands. And also the significance on how President McKinley arrived at his decision to issue his own famous benevolent assimilation policy. Also, in this topic, we learn a new language, and that is the English language. That meaningfully, it is a tool on communication through other countries. In a way, their understanding will be made with us. That for me, as a student and a person, American period have a really contribution on us Filipinos. In a reason, they are the one makes us learn and have knowledge about English language. That unfortunately, this language is origin on them to made us communicate for them and to made an understanding on them. And next, my 8th reflection topic on midterm is entitled about Commonwealth of the Philippines. This is really about establishment of our country's independence in order to the Filipinos like us will be given the good power and responsibility to manage affairs under the American supervision that mainly led by President Manuel Quezon. That this is really an important for us Filipino because of our country's independence, we are all now have a freedom to do as what we like in this country, free will to choose and to talk whatever we like. We are all have independency and self-governance that we all Filipinos do what every we do, that no one or nothing will interfere or on us doing that particular act. That for me, I feel about is I feel happy and blessed because independence is really important on us humans to act freely and to do what everything that we wanted to do in this world. And next, for my 9th reflection topic on midterm is entitled about World War II. In this World War II, on the year 1941 to 1945 in the Philippines, it was really a scenario about the country of Japan was launched a surprise attack on the country Philippines in the side of Luzon in the Manila on the 1941. It was really 10 hours after the attack on the Pearl Harbor and the bombardment was followed by the landings of the enemy troops on the both north and south of Manila and then the war started. This particular event or scenario is really makes me sad in a reason that many people who died suffer and struggle on that war makes the family of every Filipino soldiers who fight or worry so much that their wives thinking that their husband is still alive or not, which is sad to hear. And lastly, my 10th or my last topic on my midterm reflection is entitled about XU History Mindanao Phase 1. This topic contains about the Anglo-Chinese trade and it were moved in the international trade patterns in the late 1700s. The various actors that significantly who are part on the trade are the Chinese and their particular marketplace as we called commodities are tea, bird nest, pearl, tripang, and tortoise shell that for the truth it is their best basic goods or product that they have on their place. It is also an economic good. Moreover, there is one expensive marine product that where most Chinese people liked, that is tripang or sea cucumber. That it can be cooked on different style like fried, raw, and pickled, that have a slippery texture, slime, and taste bland, and also have a benefits on us humans that reducing our risk health problems in diabetes, cancer, and heart disease. This particular topic on scenarios activities is really vital on us Filipinos to know that it can help our knowledge and ideas can be widened at the same time added into our new thoughts about this particularly events and feel, and for me, I feel happy and a little bit importance because with this topic, I knew about the sea cucumber have health benefits on us humans, especially on health problems. And that's all my reflection topics on my midterm. Thank you.